You are exiles. We are the exiles. We are the fallen.
You made the decision to go after Strange Flesh. This is about one thing. This is about us being consumed by another race. Let's get them in a host body system so we can destroy them. You're a kingdom divided. You're good and evil. You are the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. To rectify that situation, you got to be turned up. It's how you know that you know Jesus. And if it doesn't add up to the scriptures, then it's not true.
All right, guys, God bless you. Welcome to This Is It, 4321. Let's go. Guys, the global situation is so out of control. It's moving faster and faster and faster. Like birth pains. Have you noticed? There's another race about to be born on this earth. And they're taking center stage. Can't you see it? It's so obvious. I can see it in everything now. Everything. It's manifesting in everything. So I thought I'd play something for you. Zach did. I asked Zach if he would make a video using the song Come Home. Now, you remember the Lord had me do this get together called A Night Under the Stars. He had revealed our identities to us in a very supernatural way. And he had a get together that he had me commit to even before he made the revelation. And then with Corey and Zach in the car, he said, if you go out to the ark tonight, I'll show up and prove to you that one of your eyes goes to a star. That's your identity. You're the stars in the sky. You're my children. You're the lights. I was like, that's crazy. I said in front of Corey and Zach. We went out there that night. And he said, go now. I was with Corey and Zach at a dinner. And he said, you need to go now. And we left. We went out to the ark. And this is before everybody came to the night under the stars. We were getting it ready. We went out. And I was standing in the building, this little building called the ark. And while I was talking to Jim and Karen and Corey and Zach and Alex and Alyssa, I looked up and there's this perfect eye in the sky. I mean, like, made by God. A rainbow eye in the sky, green and pink, but a perfect eye with all the stars out. It was so miraculous. We were all, and see, those of us that knew that the Lord said, if you go out there tonight, I'll prove your eye goes to a star. I'll prove it tonight. And we had very overcast weather. It didn't look like you're going to be able to see, you know, past a few hundred feet with a huge, heavy cloud layer and all that. It looked like there's no way that we're, I had no idea what he meant. He said, I'll show up and I'll prove it. And we went out there, and sure enough, he showed up as a giant eye in the sky with all the stars out. Okay. I want you to watch this video that Zach did. And I want to just make a point also. There's no trademark claiming it off on my behalf whatsoever. I'm just playing you a video that someone else made. So it's really good. Y'all ready? Watch this. Check out this vid.
Hello world, hope you're listening. Forgive me if I'm young or speaking out of time. There's someone I've been missing, and I think that they could be the better half of me. They're in the wrong place, trying to make it right. I'm tired of justifying, so I say to you, come home, come home. 'Cause I've been waiting for you for so long, for so long. And right now there's a war between the vanity. come home. I get lost in the beauty of everything I see. The world ain't half as bad as they paint it to be. All the sons, all the daughters, stop to take it in. Well, hopefully the hate subsides and the love can begin. It might start now, yeah. Well, maybe I'm just dreaming out loud. Well, until then, come home, come home. 'Cause I've been for so long, for so long. Right now there's a war between the vanities, but all I see is you and me. The fight for you is all I've ever known, ever known. So come
Yeah, right there. So I want y'all to consider this. The night I got saved, I was told to read the tags in the clothes I was carrying. Didn't make any sense. I was with a girl. Her name, Eleuthera, means licentious freedom. That's what it means in Greek, in the Bible, liberty. The word is Eleuthera, it means liberty, but it means legitimate or licentious freedom, and we as angels took licentious freedom. I know that because the night I got saved was a manifestation of it. I was living it, so I can't argue that it is exactly what it was. And see, one new man from the two. See how that cross that was upside down? Let me show you some. Christ's purpose was to make one new man from the two. There's an upside down you, which is evil. There's a right side up you, which is good. Now, I want you to think of it in bigger terms now. There's God from heaven, and there's the angel of death from the pit. They are two different entities. Forget about you. Forget about you. Take yourself out of the equation. There's good and evil that are in opposition to each other. But when the evil gets turned up, they're no longer in opposition. They're at peace. Understand? So those two energies now, put them inside of you, good and evil. The angel of the bottomless pits in you and the angel from the heaven, Jesus, the angel of light is in you as well. And all you have to do is call on the angel from heaven, Jesus, and say, please take my sins from me. And he'll turn you the opposite direction. You'll see the world as it truly is. You'll see both sides of the equation, not just. See, you're living seeing the upside down side. You don't even know you're inverted. But when you invert the world, you see the whole equation and you become whole as well. you become whole. Instead of this, you become this. Together, one new man from the two. Why do you think Peter was crucified upside down? Did you know in John chapter 21, Jesus told Peter, in John chapter 21, he said, Peter, do you love me? Because Peter denied him three times. He said, yes, Lord, you know I love you. Then feed my sheep. What's the virgin when I turn it the opposite direction? It's a sheep, right? Yes or no? When I turn that virgin image of the virgin I've shown you 1,000 times over, it's a dead sheep. But I can do it with all kinds of other imagery, whether or not it's a card from my wife, it's a dead sheep. It's a serpent eating a sheep. It's a statue in downtown Grand Junction. It's a serpent eating a sheep. It's a no-brainer. So when you get turned up, all your sins are forgiven because the Son of Man is lifted up inside of you. Do you understand? Instead of Lucifer sitting in the midst of you, the Son of Man stands up in the midst of you and takes that cross for you, and you become whole. It's the most supernatural conversion there is. But so again, the night I got saved, the Lord told me, Jonathan, read the tags in the clothes you're carrying. Does that make any sense to you? Doesn't that just sound as crazy? But the Lord told me, you have to go on YouTube and give a testimony. I was like, no, please, no. They're a bunch of savages. He told me, you have to. And I'm like, oh my gosh. So I did. I went down to the St. Anthony. I had Crisco with me. We documented it. Told you exactly how it rolled out. So the night I got saved, when the Lord told me in that hotel room, St. Anthony, Jonathan, by the way, St. Anthony means the priceless one. Priceless one. And I received the priceless one that night. When he told me to read those tags, I read the first tag. And it said 100% nylon. I thought maybe I lost my mind. I'm not kidding. I'm like, okay, some source is actively communicating with me, telling me to read the tags in the clothes I was carrying. I had some clothes in my hands. And the shirt I threw down on the bed said 100% nylon. And I read it out loud. I thought maybe I'd lost my mind. And I looked at the ceiling and I said, 100% nylon? That doesn't make any sense at all. Jesus told Peter in John chapter 21 that his death would glorify God. Peter, do you love me? Yes, Lord, I love you. Then feed my sheep. Because see, Peter would be crucified upside down. Jesus knew it. He said again, Peter, do you love me? A second time, Peter said, Lord, you know I love you. Then feed my sheep. How do I feed the sheep? What's the only way I really feed the sheep? I turn the world upside down for them and show them the hidden world that is right in front of their face. That it's a demonic world, that it's her. The whole thing is her. The whole system is female, Mother Earth. We're angels from heaven, our Father in heaven. We came into her system and she is destroying us. It's so obvious, right? A third time he said, Peter, do you love me? And he had denied him three times. So the Lord was restoring him of sorts. And also, it's a very important number, three, representing not just the angel of the bottomless pit, but the trilogy of the two Jonathans being made whole through Christ. So my two came together in one in Christ. And the third time he said, Peter, do you love me? And he said, you know I love you, and you know all things. And he said, then feed my sheep. Peter, when you were younger, you went where you wanted. But when you're older, you'll gird yourself, and others will take you where thou wouldest not go. Jesus said these words to Peter to show him what kind of death he would die to glorify God. Well, then he also was given the keys to the kingdom of heaven in Matthew 16. So this represents Peter and all of us. We're the upside down black cross. That's you. This is you. You got your body. It's evil, but you still have this attachment to heaven in one eye. But one eye goes to the pit, the dark one. Well, ready? Then the Lord said, Jonathan, turn the word nylon upside down. And I was like, 100%. Okay, well, sound out nylon upside down and backwards. And I went, no lion. Let me show you what 100% no lion looks like. Watch. One new man from the two, thus making peace. Because, see, you're not at peace. You're in opposition. You're in odds with yourself just because you're in the flesh. The flesh is opposed to the Spirit of the living God. It says in the Bible, read Romans. So you can't please God in the flesh. You have to be born again. And when you're born again, you're like, oh, wow. And then you don't want the stuff that the flesh normally wanted. That kind of goes away. And it takes a while. But, you know, you get a new energy. You're completely converted. Your eyes become single. And you're a new creation in Christ. And guess what? You get off with no penalty, scot-free. You got a host body, and you lived out your entire life with no penalty. Is there any greater gift than that? What is there? I mean, what else could you possibly, what should it profit a man if he gains the whole world and loses his soul? And Jesus wants to give you your soul back, and so do I. I've stepped out as far on limbs as I can. I don't know. I'm like, guys, I'll step all the way to the end of the limb. Barack Obama's the Antichrist, everybody. Guess what? Woohoo! I showed the FBI all this stuff. I showed them the bombings on the money. I showed them what's coming. I showed them the bombings that will happen, that are printed on the $100 bill, on the $10 bill. They're going to happen on the $50 bill. They didn't print them on the bills not to do them, but it's an entity that's doing it through the host body system. Do you understand? How do you think the images got printed on the money? Do you understand? Step out of the world and step into the world that the Lord's let me see. And then you can see clearly. You can see all things. He's taught me the language of angels. I've shared it with you. You think Detective Spooner's badge 4084 could mean I apprehend, catch, and arrest? And then I can do that thousands of times. You don't want to go to the movies with me. Because I'm sitting there, I just decrypt it straight through the movie. It's that obvious now. Anyway, I love you in Christ. The end of the world's here. I blew the trumpet. I warned the people. I'm going to watch that video one more time. Y'all are stars from heaven, and they want you to be stars in the flesh, and they'll give it to you, but they'll consume your energy. They'll consume your soul while you're doing it. What do you think they consume? 400. Shut up, YG.
Hello world, hope you're listening. Forgive me if I'm young or speaking out of time. There's someone I've been missing, and I think that they could be the better half of me. They're in the wrong place, trying to make it right. I'm tired of justifying, so I say to you, come home, 'cause I've been waiting for you for so long, and right now there's a war between the vanities, but all I see is you and me, and the fight for you. Come home. I get lost in the beauty of everything I see. The world ain't half as bad as they paint it to be. For the sun, all the daughters will stop to take it in. Well, hopefully the hate subsides and the love can begin. It might start now, yeah. Well, maybe I'm just dreaming out loud. Well, until then, come home, come home, 'cause I've been waiting for you everything I can be, is everything you should be, and that's why I need you here. So hear this now, come home, 'cause I've been waiting for you for so long, for so long.
Peter, do you love me? There you go. Your death will glorify God, Peter, but you have the keys to the kingdom of heaven, and that's the same keys the Lord gave me, 100% nylon. Turn it upside down. You want to know the truth? Is there a the truth? Here's the truth. Go read Genesis 2, unless he stretch forth his hand and take also again from the tree of life and live forever. You know what? I'll show it to you. How about that? I'll just show it to you. Ready? Genesis 2, to enfold. Just like I do with my hands all the time. I enfold my hands, showing you that you have an eye that goes to heaven. Like the eye in the sky, night under the stars. The Lord said, I'll prove it. He did. You have an eye that goes to the pit. The Lord showed me, I'll prove it. There's an eye on the floor in the Vatican right under the canopy. It's the eye of a serpent with locusts coming up from the pit. He proved it. He showed me. He proved it. I'm like, okay, eye goes to the pit, to a locust. I will restore to you the years the locust has eaten, the caterpillar, Justin Timberlake, no more angels down on the dance floor. You know, come on. It's just stupid obvious now. The Lord obviously made me a prophet, and I'm trying just to do the best I can. It's really a tough job, by the way. But let me show you just how obvious this and truthful. The scriptures, the word of God is everything. The word of God endures forever. It never, ever fails, ever. The word of God is everything. Here we go. Genesis 3, I'm sorry. And the Lord God said, behold, man is become as one of us. Ready? Look at this. What does it say? United. That is one. Oh, as what? The angel and the demon combo. Ready? Man, a host body system, is become as one, properly united together, one of us, to know good and evil. There it is. Now, because you're in a host body and you know that and you have a soul, now watch this. Now, lest, and I have this highlighted, this bright pink for a reason, to turn, by implication, to face. Now, lest, unless you turn back, ready? Unless you turn back, lest he turn and put forth his hand and take also, ready, to take, to enfold, to mingle, to take again from the tree of life and live forever. 100% nylon. Told you. 100% no line. One new man from the two. Thus making peace. How simple. Simplest thing in the world. Most paradoxical. That's how you know it's the Lord God, because it's so simple, but it's so paradoxical and it's so genius. It's beyond the human brain. And then he got some miscreant named Yahweh has given. Oh, I mean Jonathan Kleck. Yahweh has given a bell ringer and a messenger that rings the bell and gathers the church. That's what Jonathan Kleck means. He told me to look up the meaning of my name. It was important because he knew me before he formed me in my mother's womb. Do you believe that? Well, I can show you all the stuff. All these other channels that claim they, you know, whatever, work for the Lord. Most of them don't. They're there for views. I'm not monetized. I don't care about views. I'm here to save souls, guys. I know I'm being suppressed, my channel. I used to have millions of views on videos. 5 million views, 8 million views, and then all of a sudden, what? No. Yeah. The end's here. The new race is birthed. It's birthing right now. What you're watching are birth pains. What do you think all this is? What do you think the Olympics was? It was a manifestation of the Word of God. But who could show you out of everybody on YouTube that the Bible was a manifestation of different verses in the Bible? Who could show you that? He's the only one. And he showed it through his servant to you. But now everyone that saw it's responsible for it. So, it's either the best day of your life or the worst. That's the way this works. It's either the best day of your life because you reached out again and you turned. What does it say? Unless you turn. Man has become as one of us, united together with good and evil. And now, lest... properly, removal, see it? Removal, and it says, lest, removal, to turn, to return self. Now, ready? Think of the Lord God, the creator of all things, that created this system. Well, when he has himself in you, turn back to himself, he's restored a piece of himself. Why do you think he's the self-existent, eternal Jehovah? Because he restores himself in you and me. We're the restoration. Do you get it? It's that profound. Yes. Now, lest he put forth his hand and take. What's the word take mean? To take, to accept, to enfold. Also of the tree of life and live forever. What does it say? To revive by turning you back the other way, turning you up. Ready? To live, to revive, to keep alive, to make alive, to give promise, to quicken, to recover, to repair, to restore, to be whole. And live forever. Did he let me solve the riddle of ages? All glory to the King. He just showed you the riddle of ages in Genesis 3. Unless you enfold and turn back towards the tree of life and live forever. I just showed you in the scriptures. It's the exact vocabulary of everything I've been showing you. All right, this is you. I love you in Christ. This is you. If you received what I just gave you, then you received more value than all the money in the world. You received more value than anything you could possibly get if you received what the Lord just let me give you. That's you. And here's all you got to do. You turn back to your dad who loves you because he loves you. Period. He came into the flesh to get you because you were trapped in a system called the flesh that you cannot beat. He's the only one that could pay the price. And here's a hug from dad through me to you. It's going to be all right. All right, guys. Jesus truly does love you. It's not just words. All right, peace and grace.